Okay, so the second week of evolution, and we want to go through sources of variation, evolutionary patterns, evidence, speciation, and modern evolutionary theories this week. Okay, let's just review. When the environment changes, there's limited resources. That leads to selection pressures and competition. Those that are best suited to the environment are able to pass on their genes, and we say they have inherited adaptations to that particular environment. And that leads to species diversity. So that's what we basically looked at last week when we talked about the theory of natural selection. This week, we want to ask ourselves, well, what are the sources of variation originally? Okay, what caused the sources of variation in the original population? And there's two sources: mutations and sexual reproduction. So we want to look at both of these. Okay, when it comes to mutations, mutations are anything that is going to cause a change in the DNA. Okay, so here's my DNA. Here's the original DNA. If we change one of the base pairs in the nucleic acid, we get a mutation. Okay, so we talked a bit about nucleic acids in the biochemistry unit very briefly, two types, DNA and RNA. When we get a change in the DNA, this can be caused by environmental factors like chemicals. Radiation would be an example of a physical environmental factor like UV radiation, and that can actually lead to a mutation. Mutations are rare, but can be substantial over many generations. So, mutations that are beneficial could be things like skin color, okay? Having more melanin in your skin would be a beneficial mutation if you happen to be born in mid-latitudes, so equatorial regions rather, so where there's a lot of intense UV radiation. If you're born with that mutation, that's beneficial. If you're born with a mutation for light skin, though, that is beneficial in northern climes because it maximizes solar incoming radiation. You can make vitamin D. So when we talk about mutation, we usually have a negative connotation. It's something bad. And many mutations are, and if they survive in the gene pool, they can lead to diseases. But again, they're the original source of variation, slight changes in your DNA. The other one is sexual reproduction. And one of your bullets says, discuss the significance of sexual reproduction, individual variation in populations, and the process of evolution. Well, let's compare it with asexual. Asexual would be these bacteria here, which are prokaryotes, and they don't have a true nucleus. And when they divide, they will produce identical offspring. Okay? So any variation would rely on mutations or DNA does get exchanged between a bacteria. We'll go through that in more detail in Bio30. Well, when we have sexual reproduction, that's essentially a mixing of genes from parents, okay? And so there's competition here. You can see this in the peacocks. They're going to compete for the hens, okay? So the mating is not random because of competition. Only certain peacocks get to mate with the hens. And different partners mating leads to even more variety. And that's because you're going to be mixing the gene pool even more between two different members of the same species. So sexual reproduction and mutation is the source of variation in a population. Okay, we're going to look at evolutionary patterns in the next video.